I want to talk to you about the baptism of the Holy Spirit and speaking of tongues. It is very much evident that once you receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit manifests in you through the gift of tongues. Jesus said in Mark's Gospel, chapter 16, verse 17, "And these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name they will drive out demons, they will speak in new tongues." So Jesus said that this is a sign for those who believe. Also in Acts chapter 2, verse 4, we see on the day of Pentecost, all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. The day the apostles were baptized in the Holy Spirit, the first sign that came out of them was as a result of the baptism of the Holy Spirit was the gift of speaking in tongues. And in various other passages, in Acts chapter 10, verses 44 to 46, we read that while Peter was still speaking these words, the Holy Spirit came on all who heard the message. Peter was preaching, and there were people who were listening to the message. As they were listening to the message, the Holy Spirit came upon them. And they were all astonished that the gift of the Holy Spirit has been poured out even on the Gentiles. And in verse 46 it says, "For they heard them speaking in tongues and praising God." The gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out onto the Gentiles, and the result was that they were speaking in tongues and praising God. Also in Acts chapter 19, verse 6, when Paul placed his hands on those people, the Holy Spirit came on them and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. So here we see Paul placing his hands on those people whom he was preaching to, and the Holy Spirit comes on them and they spoke in tongues. In 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 10, the great chapter which gives us details about the nine gifts of the Holy Spirit, talking about the various gifts, in verse 10 it says, "To another speaking in different kinds of tongues, and to still another interpretation of the tongues." You know, the tongues is so important that Paul the Apostle went on to say in 1 Corinthians 14:18, "I thank God that I speak in tongues more than all of you." Paul the Apostle said this, "I speak in tongues more than all of you." That shows how important speaking in tongues is. 1 Corinthians 12:28 says this, "And God has placed in the church first of all apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then miracles, then gifts of healing, of helping, of guidance, and different kinds of tongues." Notice, it's a different kinds of tongues. The King James Version says, "diversity of tongues." What is the diversity of tongues? What do you mean by different kinds of tongues? I believe there are three different kinds of tongues. Number one, like in the day of Pentecost, when people of all nationality were gathered together, and the apostles, when the Holy Spirit came upon them, they started speaking in tongues. The Bible says that they started speaking in the native language, which was unknown to them, unknown to the speaker. They spoke in the native language of those who had gathered there, listening to them. So the first type of tongue is you speak the native language of a person belonging to another country in a language that you do not know. Okay? The second type of tongue that we see is like it said in 1 Corinthians 14:2, you speak to God directly in prayer. It's a prayer language that the Holy Spirit gives you. 1 Corinthians 14:2 says, for anyone who speaks in a tongue does not speak to people, but to God. When you speak in tongues, you speak to God. It's a conversation with God, not with any man. Indeed, no one understands them. They utter mysteries by the Spirit. You utter mysteries by the Spirit when you speak in tongues to God. It's an angelic tongue. Nobody knows what it is. Only God understands that. And you, without your own knowledge, you speak great mysteries with God. What a tremendous experience that is, to be speaking mysteries with God in an unknown heavenly language. The third thing is, you speak in tongues and someone interprets, which is a message to somebody else in the congregation. So these are the three types of tongues, I believe. One is you speak when the Spirit enables you, you speak in the native language of a foreigner. Number two, you speak to God in prayer, uttering mysteries in the Spirit which no man understands. Number three, you speak in tongues and then either you or someone else interprets, which is always a message for somebody else in the congregation. So we have to long. The secret to be baptized in the Holy Spirit is thirst. That's what Jesus cried out in John chapter 7. If any man thirsts, so if you really thirst for this, God will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. I will leave you with this. 1 Corinthians 14:4 says, anyone who speaks in a tongue edifies themselves. Wow. When you speak in tongues, you keep edifying or building up your spirit man. Are you struggling with fleshly desires which you are unable to overcome? Speak in tongues at least for an hour a day, and you will find your spiritual life enriched, strengthened, and you may be able to overcome these physical weaknesses that you have. My friend, keep that in mind. A man who speaks in tongues edifies himself. May God bless you.